Hi everyone! Today, I'm going to show you how to turn simple Excel data into a powerful and dynamic recruitment dashboard using Power BI. Let's dive into the dashboard and see what it has to offer. Right away, you'll see two key metrics, the number of open positions and open applications. Below them, there are two horizontal bar charts. One shows a breakdown of open positions by department, and the other shows open applications by source. These charts give a quick overview of where your recruitment efforts are concentrated, helping you allocate resources more effectively. Next, we have a lollipop chart that displays the number of open positions or applications by HR teams. You can toggle between showing open positions or open applications using a drop-down list. This chart makes it easy to compare team performance and workload distribution. Below the lollipop chart, you'll find two tables. The first table lists open positions. You can hover over a position to see additional details like department, employment type, job level, hiring manager, HR team, HR partner, and more. The second table shows open applications. Similarly, hovering over an applicant's name lets you view details such as the applied job ID and title, application stage, job department, and the involved hiring parties. These tables provide in-depth information at a glance, making it easy to manage and review entries efficiently. On the top right, there's a visual showing the stages of the recruitment process: screening, interviewing, evaluation, offering, and confirmation. Each stage displays the current number of open applications and the average days spent at each stage. This helps you track the progression of applications and identify any bottlenecks in your hiring process. Below the recruitment process, you'll find metrics that provide a comprehensive view of your recruitment performance over the past year, including total hires, average days to hire, and the offer rejection rate. There's also a pie chart that shows the rejection counts by reason, giving insights into why offers are being rejected, helping you identify issues. At the bottom, we have the trend chart that shows applications closed as columns and positions filled as a line for the last 12 months. It allows you to track trends over time, helping you monitor changes in recruitment activity month by month and assess the effectiveness of your strategies. Now, let's explore the interactive features of the dashboard. You can customize it by HR team, department, or even down to individual positions. To analyze the recruitment performance of a specific HR team, simply click on any team in the lollipop chart, and the entire dashboard will update to show data specific to that team. To review the data by department, click on any department in the horizontal bar chart, and the dashboard will refresh to display data related to that department only. To explore by application sources, click on any source in the application sources bar chart, and the dashboard will filter to display all related information. You can also drill down to individual positions by clicking on a position in the open positions list. The dashboard updates to show related applications, their progress, and performance over the past year. These features allows you to tailor the dashboard to your specific needs, making it a powerful tool for data-driven decision-making. If you like what you're seeing so far, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, let me show you how to make this dashboard yours in three simple steps. Step 1. Download the template. First, download the Power BI template and the Excel dataset using the link in the description below. It's completely free and easy to access. After downloading, extract the files from the zip folder, and step 1 is done. Step 2. Replace the dataset. Before diving into the Excel dataset, let's briefly go over the data structure. There are four tables in the dataset. The position table records information related to job roles or positions, such as position ID, department, employment type, job level, hiring parties, etc. The application table contains details about each application, including the application ID, applicant name, contact info, applied position ID, current stage in the recruitment process, and dates of each stage. the next two tables, HR team and source, are dimension tables that provide context for slicing and dicing the data more effectively. These tables are connected through key fields, allowing the dashboard to generate rich insights from your data. Now, let's open the Excel file. In the position worksheet, replace the sample data with your own job or position details. These fields are common recruitment data relating to the positions. Next, in the application worksheet, replace the sample data with your own application information. I have only included the basic info for the sample. You can add more columns if needed. Moving on, the HR team and source worksheets contain data specific to your organization. Update them with your own data. And with that, we are done with the Excel file setup. Step 3. Load your data to the BI template. Open the BI file in the Power BI desktop. If you don't have Power BI Desktop yet, download it free from the Microsoft website. The link is in the description. For those interested in creating the lollipop chart shown on the dashboard, I have a time-lapse video that walks you through the process. Click the link above to watch. Now, to replace the data file in Power BI, click on the Transform Data button to enter the query view. To adjust the data source settings, click on the Data Source Settings button at the top. Select the file shown, then click on Change Source. Browse and navigate to the folder where you saved your dataset, and the BI file will automatically update with the new data. To exit Query View and load your data, go to the top left corner and click Close and Apply. Give it some time to load your new data. And there you have it! By following these simple steps, you'll have a fully functional recruitment dashboard that helps you uncover key insights. Going forward, you just need to update the Excel worksheet and click the refresh button at the top to update the dashboard with the latest data. I hope you find this recruitment dashboard template helpful for your work or learning. If you are looking for more dashboard templates, be sure to check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.